In these next two examples, we're asked to rewrite a trig expression using a half angle identity. Here we have sine of 5x raised to the second power. So we'll be applying the half angle identity for sine. So there's a couple things we have to remember here. First, notice how this function is being squared, so it's not a perfect fit. And if we want to rewrite a square root using a rational exponent, remember the square root of x is equal to x to the power of 1/2. So let's start by taking this half angle identity and squaring both sides. And we'll also rewrite this square root using a rational exponent. So we'll have plus or minus, this will be 1 minus cosine a divided by 2 raised to the 1/2 power squared. The next rule we have to remember is when we have a power to a power, we multiply our exponents. So 1/2 times 2 is going to equal 1. And since we're squaring this, this plus or minus goes away because if we square a positive, it's positive. And if we square a negative, it's still positive. So we have the sine of a over 2 squared is going to be equal to 1 minus cosine a divided by 2. So the next step is to determine what is the value of a given sine of 5x squared. Well, 5x has to equal a over 2. So if we set a over 2 equal to 5x and multiply both sides by 2, we know that a is equal to 10x. So using the half angle identities, a will always be twice the given angle. So now we have all the information we need to apply this slight variation of the half angle identity for sine. We're going to have sine of 5x raised to the second. It's going to be equal to 1 minus cosine 10x divided by 2. And if we want, we could rewrite this as 1/2 minus 1/2 cosine 10x. So there's really not a lot going on here other than getting familiar with these new half angle identities. Let's take a look at one more. Here we have cosine of 2x raised to the fourth power. So let's start by taking this half angle identity for a cosine and raising it to the fourth power. So we'll have cosine of a over 2, and we're going to raise it to the fourth power this time. It's going to be equal to plus or minus, and we'll also write this as a rational exponent again. So we'll have plus or minus, this will be 1 plus cosine a divided by 2 to the 1/2 power. And then again, we're raising both sides to the fourth power. Well, here we're going to have 1/2 times 4, that's going to be 2. So we have cosine of a over 2 raised to the fourth. It's going to be equal to 1 plus cosine a all over 2 raised to the second power. Again, notice how the plus and minus symbol is no longer needed because we're raising it to an even power. And remember, to square a fraction, we can square the denominator and square the numerator. So let's go ahead and multiply this out. Our denominator is going to be 4. If we multiply this out, we're going to have 1 plus cosine a times 1 plus cosine a. So we'll have 1 plus cosine a plus cosine, that's 2 cosine a. And then we'll have cosine squared a. Now we'll go ahead and apply this slight variation of the half angle identity to the given expression. And remember, if a over 2 is equal to 2x, the angle in the half angle identity, if we multiply both sides by 2, we'll have a equals 4x. So when we apply this identity, we'll have cosine of 2x raised to the fourth power is going to be equal to 1 plus 2 cosine 4x plus cosine squared 4x, all divided by 4. And we could factor out the 1/4 to have 1/4 times the quantity 1 plus 2 cosine 4x plus cosine squared 4x. And of course, we could also distribute the 1/4, but I think we'll go ahead and leave it like this. Again, other than doing some manipulations to these half-angle identities, there's not a lot going on here other than becoming more familiar with these identities.